and I am delighted to be associated with Promised Dad for many, many reasons. The first thing is that it's reunited me with a lot of old friends. Tom Alto Saab, who did Zaban Sambhalki with me for years and years. Jugal Hansraj, who was in school with me. Satish Kaushik, who spent 80 marvelous days with me in New York when we shot for Rahab Lot Chali. Rasool, our sound recordist and sound designer, with whom I did my first English film, I forgot to identify. But apart from this reunion with old friends whom you will all meet after we see the trailer, this film marks the debut of a filmmaker. A filmmaker whose name is Ritesh Sinha. Ladies and gentlemen, he's standing right here. Could we give him a big hand? Ritesh, can I call you? Thank you. Ritesh and me fight every day. He is the director in the true sense of the word. When he makes a film, the budget, how to make it, nothing matters except the vision. And for a director to have vision and to single-handedly produce, direct, edit, and write a film in English, and to get it a wide release in the United Kingdom, which he will tell you about, is not a small achievement, ladies and gentlemen. It's an extremely big achievement, which is why I'm very proud to be associated with Ritesh and to be associated with the film. I had promised Ritesh, whenever we have the first outing of this film, which is today, I would personally hold him by his hand and introduce him to you, my friends in the industry, and there's a lot of them here. Sudhir is here, Sudhir Mishra, Rahul Bhatt, who's been a very old friend, Avtar, who's been an old friend, Sanjeev Puri, who's written 3 films for me, and so many others. Milab Zaveri, who's Masti Zadeh I'm acting in. And ladies and gentlemen, here you are, Ritesh Sinha, a wonderful new addition to your fraternity.
Thank you, Vivek. I think you have said a lot more than what I deserve. Well, but it's true that it takes your life to make a feature film if you're doing it all by yourself. I think a lot of you will identify with this phenomena. And the only problem was that I wanted to make this in an English film because I felt that the story set in the world of ice skating and yet a very emotional story about a father and a son has a wider global appeal. But it was a kind of a journey to engage with people to see if I can get funding and backing and which didn't happen. Then apparently I had to discuss with my family. I sold a couple of my flats in Bombay and this is what you will see. And I hope I don't go down the drain into the sea. I hope something comes out of it. But I'm happy. I think it's just begun and I really wanted that promise that though I'm looking at the global scenario, I wanted ki apne Mumbai se iski journey shuru ho. So I'm very happy that you all have come. I'd like to show you the trailer first. It's just a glimpse of the entire story what Promised Dad is all about. And once you have seen the trailer, I'd like all my cast and crew to join me on this celebration. So let's have a look at the trailer first. Thank you so much. This is just a kind of a teaser to the story, what Promised Dad is all about. And it's not just a story about, I would suggest, an individual, but it's about a mindset that sometimes we have to go beyond our circumstances, what we are, what we are conditioned, and then perhaps we get what we deserve in life. So I think I'm hopeful that this kind of a story is a human story and it should connect with the audiences irrespective of what nation or what language we are talking about. But this journey wouldn't have been possible if, to start with, I would say if Rasul wouldn't have read my script and said that it's a nice script, why don't you go ahead and try making it? Or if Satish ji wouldn't have said that I like the script and I like to play Raman's character. So, I mean, it's just filmmaking is actually a collaborative effort, so the journey has to be together. And I take this opportunity to invite all my team members one by one to be with me and just be part of the celebration. And I'll start with Satish ji, you, if you can join me. Come on, guys. Come on, loud cheer. Thank you, Satish ji, for being here. He's been a great support. And I think he performed so well. I remember he had his he had three pages of dialogues. And he would arrive 2 hours or an hour before the time I would actually officially ask him to. And I would see him rehearsing, you know. That he said, no, I want to give my perfection. And imagine, I mean, he's a legend. This is my first film. I don't know how many you have done, but still he had that passion. So thank you, sir, for supporting this little endeavor of mine. And I hope if you can say a few words.
Hi, good evening, everyone. This is a very important film because Ritesh is a very dear friend, colleague. He has worked with me before. And when he narrated me the subject of Promised Dad, I thought it was a very compact, emotional and very human drama told in a very, very emotional manner. And I loved the part which he gave me. It was my outing after Brick Lane and Road Movie as an international film and an English film. And it was great honor and great enjoyment to do this film because the background of the film was skating, which was very new to us, but it was very exciting on the screen. And if you see on the screen the kind of skating stunts this boy has done, this, he's not here, I think he's not come, Tom is not here, but, and he chose him out of the blue. He's not even an actor, he's just a skater, but the kind of performance he has given is amazing. So I congratulate you. And everybody connected with the Promised Dad. It is going to be a very, very interesting film, very heartwarming, heart-wrenching film, you can say that. And congrats, Ritesh. Best of luck to you and best of luck to everyone.
Thank you, Satish ji. And this journey again would have been complete if Tom Walter Sahab wouldn't have brought Mahabharat the way this film has a very beautiful narrative of Mahabharat woven within the story, which we will see in the entire film. And Tom Walter Sahab, you were just truly great. Join us. Welcome, sir. Just a couple of words, sir, if you would like to share what and how the journey was.
Film bani angrezi mein, lekin main hindi mein baat kar raha hu. Ye film banana kisi Mahabharat se kam nahi tha. Hum sab ke liye, no. It was an amazing journey, and as Satish ji said, when I was approached out of the blue by this handsome young man here, it was the story that caught my eye. It was a tremendous story, emotional. As you just said, it could be the story of any country, any race. The sport which is picked up, ice skating, since it's not an Indian sport, obviously it made more sense to shoot in England. But the way that this man has, every filmmaker works very hard. Many filmmakers are sitting right here, koi nayi baat nahi hai. But the way this man said, mujhe bas yehi karna hai, jis zid ki aap baat kar rahe the pehle, bahut ziddi aadmi hai, lekin ziddi hona bahut zaruri hai agar aap achhi film banana chahte hain to. So it's been a great pleasure. I'm so happy to see that the film is skating its way to the light of day. And the Tom that you mentioned is not me, by the way. I skate very, very badly. It's a younger version of me, Tom, who is brilliant. A young, slim English boy. I don't think he's ever acted in a movie. Has he done any acting at all? He's just a professional ice skater, and he's given such a performance, and to work with him was absolutely fantastic. But in the end, I want to say one of the great pleasures was working with Satish. I've had very little chance to work with him down through my more than 40 years in this industry. But to work with you, Satish, in a language, English, which is foreign to both of us, and to me also, sir, I'm Hindustani. It was tremendous, and as you said, I love the way that he approached the English dialogues as if they were his own. He didn't try to put on some fake accent or anything. He spoke English as Satish would speak English, and he's done an absolutely marvelous job. So I wish the film all the very, very best, and may you go on to make many, many more. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. I would like to now invite Jewel and Natasha, both of you, if you can join us. This I'm calling them jointly because this particular track in the story wouldn't have been perfect if Jugal and Natasha wouldn't have done it, because I wanted a very, there was a particular look I had in mind for the couple who fly down from New Delhi to London to figure out about Satish Kaushik Saab's character Raman. And after a lot of thinking and a lot of, you know, brainstorming, we came down to, and I didn't know that Jugal will, he's been busy doing so many other things, he's been traveling all around the world. So I said, would you like to do a part in my film? And he was like, you know, I'm a little busy, but let me figure out and I'll let you know. And I thank you, brother, for agreeing to the film. And I think it's shaped up very, very well. And same here, Natasha, I think you are in India, and I think this is a beautiful film, and your career, you know, it's a nice beginning. So let's just share your thoughts on this.
Yeah, good evening. I think I'd met Ritesh first some time back, many months ago, when he had come back from England after the schedule of Promised Dad. And he had shown me some clips on his computer. And I thought, you know, he's a first-time director, he's done a wonderful job, and he was telling me about the film with so much passion. And then I didn't really know that I would be a part of it. Many months later, he gave me a call and said, you know, he's added a track to weave everything together. And, you know, would I like to hear it? So I heard him out, and I had already seen the clips and liked them very much. And of course, to be in a film, you know, when Mr. Satish Kaushik is there, Tom Alter, such genuine, you know, great actors, and the film itself, you know, it had a very emotional core, something that, you know, made me feel like I want to watch it. And then when I got a chance to be a part of it, I thought, you know, even if it's a small part, I would definitely like to be a part of it. And I would like to, you know, congratulate Ritesh. I've heard how difficult his journey was to get this film released. He's done everything on his own without any backing, and I think in some small way, if I could be, you know, a support, I think, and I wish him and everybody all the best.
Thank you. Natasha, a few words.
Good evening, everyone. When I heard the story first time, for me, it was like, wow, it's like very realistic. And I think a lot of people will find themselves, even I found myself there, because I struggled in my ballet school and my family was there for me. So I'm very thankful to you that you chose me for your movie, and even if it's a small part, I'm very happy. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you for being part of the film. And yes, as I said, the whole thing started with Resul Saab reading the script. So if I can have you, sir, here. And I thank you for again being here and supporting us. A few words.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much. Yeah, it started off about 4 years ago. On an Eid day, lunch at home, that we started. I thought ice skating is so alien to us as film. So he had the guts to go ahead and shoot and, you know, get it done in a way. Here we're talking about ice skating. So he had this conviction that, you know, whether it is ice skating or cricket or anything, a sports film has its own energy and its own, you know, fair share of people who would watch it. And more than anything, it's a human story. It's a struggle. It's a father's struggle. A father who believed in his son. It's his struggle. It's a son's, you know, struggle to fulfill his promise to his father. So it's many levels it works. And for me, my greatest joy is Satish Ji and Tom Alter. And especially Satish Ji, I never even had to crib about, you know, clarity of sound. Everything he speak is so clear. And I see so many years of experience. I see actors who wants to communicate with their audience. I see that inner energy in every bit of every frame of the performance. I'm so happy that I am with them again. And thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you. I like you to come here. He's the person who's putting life through music in my film, and I've been doing it recently, all the reels, and it's shaped up beautifully. So Sanjay, I'd like you to share a few thoughts on the film.
I wouldn't like to say anything, actually, but let my music speak. When you see the film, I think you'll realize, I'm rather not a narrator. I kind of express myself through music, and the kind of screenplay that he's given me to do is quite challenging, actually. And Russo wants live all the time. So anyway, I think he'll be taking me to Chennai to do the live section. We're still completing the film. We've just come halfway. So I'm just waiting for it to finish. And then if you guys see it, hear my music, see the screenplay and everything, I think that'll speak for me, I guess. Thanks so much, Ritesh.
Yes, I assure you that I think the way you are developing the whole thing is very beautiful. And I think it's added so much to the film. So I thank you for that. And all this while, to put this all thing towards the release, I had my friend Rakesh Upadhyay, if you can join me. He's been a pillar of strength all around, doing all my, you know, various kind of collaborations, release, everything. So Rakesh, you have to, I thank you here on this platform. Come here. I thank you for providing that support to our film, and we just have to fly from here. So if your thoughts on the film.
I just want to say one thing, that Ritesh is a very passionate filmmaker, and I saw the film and I felt okay, let's go and release this film all across the world. It's a lovely film, and hopefully we'll release very soon in India too.
Just to, you know, we have tried now and we have locked it. We are releasing 19th June in UK in close to 150 theatres, which is very rare for an Indian production. We have been like fighting it out to get as many, you know, audience for a film like this, because Britain and the UK is the story where the film is set, the land where the film is set. So we want to open from UK, and God willing, if the film does well, then we move on to other countries in a bigger way, hopefully. And this journey, of course, if I have to, you know, if the person who is not last, you know, but Vivek, if you can just come here, you're not even least, you're an inspiration to me. And just come and you can give your final speech to end the evening, and we'll see the trailer once more before we leave.
Thanks a lot, Avtar. Thanks a lot. Thank you, Avtar. Thanks a lot. Thanks.
Before you go, I just want to say one thing. When, you know, so many Hollywood films comes to India and take so much resources from our country, why not an Indian film made by an Indian? Language doesn't matter. Go back there, open there, and make a history. And thank you for showing that gutso, because it's a high time that we as Indian filmmakers have to think and to know that you know, bigger productions are coming and taking over our fair share of market. And for someone from this industry, whether it is new or old or whoever from industry, to stand up and say, look, we also can, you know, get into your market and take a fair share of our work and business, that takes a lot of strength and that take a lot of strife. And thank you for that. And the first one among us is, again, greatest feat. And all the best to you.
Thank you for coming. It's been a very, very brave journey. I'm deeply, deeply gratified to be part of this film. I unfortunately wish that I could have met Ritesh a little earlier. And,
is that mutual?
I only wish that films like Promised Dad, because the kind of filmmakers we all are, the kind of filmmakers who are sitting here, who are right here, we have to keep on pushing that envelope, and we have to keep on stretching to our limits as much as we can. So the only thing I can say is fortune favors the brave. God bless you all. God bless all of you. Thank you for being here. Let's see the trailer once more and go down and meet some.
बहुत ही अच्छा किरदार है, जैसे कि पिक्चर के टाइटल से साफ पता चलता है कि पिक्चर का नाम है प्रॉमिस डैड और मैं डैड का रोल कर रहा हूँ। तो ये एक बाप बेटे की बड़ी संघर्ष की कहानी है, बहुत ही इमोशनल कहानी है और बहुत ही जो दिल को छू लेने वाली जो एक व्यथा होती है, गाथा होती है, उस तरह की फिल्म है। और मेरा जो किरदार जो है वो बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग है। मेरी जो पहली फिल्म थी, मैंने ब्रिटिश फिल्म की थी ब्रिकलेन, जो कि पूरे वर्ल्ड में रिलीज हुई थी जिसके लिए मुझे बहुत ज़बरदस्त रिव्यूज़ मिले थे। उसके बाद मैंने देव बेनेगल की रोड मूवी फिल्म की, विच वॉज एन इंटरनेशनल फिल्म, एंड नाउ दिस फिल्म प्रॉमिस डैड। तो मुझे बहुत रितेश के साथ काम करने का बहुत मज़ा आया। इट वॉज़ ए ग्रेट एक्सपीरियंस बिकॉज जो फिल्म थी उसका बैकड्रॉप जो था स्केटिंग था, तो वो देख करके तो एक्साइटमेंट होता कि पूछो मत। एंड उसके ऊपर द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द फादर एंड सन इज़ वेरी वेरी ब्यूटिफुल। सो आई थिंक रितेश हैज़ कंसीव्ड ए फिल्म विच इज़ वेरी कॉम्पैक्ट, वेरी इमोशनल एंड टोल्ड इन ए वेरी वेरी हार्ट ब्रेकिंग मैनर। I'm sure that this film, which is releasing in UK in 150 theatres, as Ritesh said, you know, will make a mark, because it is a film which is based on a sport, and sports film always do well. And the success stories, you know, going from 0 to 100, and it is a very great achievement for this boy who has promised his father that he wanted to be a skater. So I had a great time shooting this film.
Indian market mein is film ko kaise dekhte hain? Sports film hai, usually sports film usually itna support nahi kiye jaate, internet se is a big star.
अपना देखिए क्या है, आजकल कोई बिग स्टार या छोटे स्टार का कोई ऐसा वो नहीं है। फिल्म अच्छी होती है तो वो अपनी जगह बना लेती है। ये अभी पिछले कुछ महीनों में और इस साल प्रूव हो गया असल में। जब आप आंखों देखिए ऐसी फिल्म देखते हैं और उसके अंदर इतना कोई ऐसे मेन स्ट्रीम एक्टर्स नहीं होते हैं, लेकिन फिर भी उस फिल्म को देखा जाता है। और अभी हमने दम लगा के आयशा फिल्म देखी, जो कि इतना ज़बरदस्त बिजनेस किया है। तो आज कोई बंधा टका रूल नहीं है, फिल्म अच्छी होती है तो वर्ड ऑफ माउथ से और धीरे धीरे उसकी बात फैलती है। ये फिल्म जो है, जबकि ये इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज में है, लेकिन मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि इसकी लैंग्वेज इतनी सरल और सीधी है और जो कहानी है वो इतने को दिल को छूने वाली है कि वो हिंदी हो या इंग्लिश, आपको समझ जो है वो बहुत अच्छी तरीके से आ जाएगी। क्योंकि जो इसके अंदर व्यथा है, जो इसके अंदर दर्द है, वो बहुत ही रिलेटेबल है। वो मतलब कोई भी आदमी, यूनिवर्सल अपील की फिल्म है ये। कोई ऐसा नहीं कि उसको हिंदी ऑडियंस के अंदर उसको लोग समझ नहीं पाएंगे। जहाँ तक बॉक्स ऑफिस का सवाल है, वो तो पिक्चर जब फर्स्ट डे लगती है तभी पता चलता है, लेकिन आई एम श्योर कि ये कहानी जो है वो लोगों के दिलों को छुएगी।
क्या आपको ऐसी टेम्पटेशन हुई कि मैं खुद डायरेक्ट
करूँ? नहीं, रितेश मेरा असिस्टेंट रह चुका है, तो रितेश डायरेक्ट कर रहा था तो मैं कैसे डायरेक्ट कर सकता था। लेकिन मुझे एक्टिंग करने का बड़ा मजा आया, बिकॉज जैसे कि मैंने कहा कि मेरी इंग्लिश फिल्म ब्रिकलेन, रोड मूवी और दिस फिल्म, दिस इज माई थर्ड फिल्म। एंड जबकि मेरी लैंग्वेज नहीं है, इंग्लिश थिएटर भी मैंने नहीं किया, जो मेरे को मैंने ब्रिकलेन में मुझे एक्सपीरियंस हुआ। यू नो, रोड मूवी तो खैर हिंदी में ही थी, लेकिन इस फिल्म के अंदर मुझको अपने डायलॉग्स बोलने में, याद करने में मतलब तकलीफ हुई, लेकिन उनको याद करके बोला और बड़े बड़े तरीके से और बहुत नेचुरल तरीके से बोला, जो मेरे लिए बड़ा चैलेंजिंग था।
आजकल आप किस चीज़ में व्यस्त हैं?
मैं आजकल ये साल जो है पूरा एक्टिंग की तरफ जा रहा है। अभी जय हो डेमोक्रेसी रिलीज हो रही है कल, है ना, उसमें मैंने एक हरियाणवी पॉलिटिशियन का रोल किया है। और उसके बाद अपना मैं एक बहुत बड़ा टीवी शो कर रहा हूँ जिसके बारे में मैं बता नहीं सकता हूँ, लेकिन उसका शूट चल रहा है और वो जून जुलाई से आना शुरू होगा. लेकिन आई कैन टॉक अबाउट दैट, आई एम नॉट सपोज टू टॉक अबाउट दैट, विच विल टेक मी बिजी टिल एंड ऑफ द ईयर. इस साल के आखिर तक मैं उसमें बिजी रहूँगा. फिर मैं अभिषेक चौबे की फिल्म कर रहा हूँ एज एन एक्टर, कुर्ता पंजाब, उसी की शूटिंग के लिए मेरा आवन जावन हो रहा है बॉम्बे अमृतसर, क्योंकि यहाँ मेरी वो टीवी शो की शूटिंग चल रही है और उधर उसकी शूटिंग चल रही है. तो ये साल जो है एक्टिंग को दिया हुआ है, थोड़ा सा डायरेक्शन को गैप दे रखा है, थोड़ा रिलैक्सिंग हुआ है, थोड़ा मजा आ रहा है.
टीवी शो रियलिटी शो है या
इट इज़ ए फिक्शनल शो विच विल कम टू नो लेटर, विच आई कांट यू नो रिवील जस्ट नाउ. फैंस ये कहेंगे कि भैया हमारी पिक्चरें देखते रहो, है ना, और हमको पसंद करते रहो, हमको प्यार करते रहो जैसे कि आप हमेशा प्यार करते आए हैं, और अच्छे बने रहो और फिल्म जो है वो सिनेमा में देखो.
सर एक लास्ट क्वेश्चन, उड़ता पंजाब में कितना स्ट्रेसफुल हो रहा है, बिकॉज बहुत चर्चाएं आ रही हैं, बहुत डिफिकल्ट है फिल्म, बहुत डिफरेंट है, कितना स्ट्रेसफुल है अब तक का स्केड्यूल हो रहा है?
नहीं, मैं तो खैर भी गया हूँ, लेकिन पिक्चर की जो स्क्रिप्ट है वो बहुत ही दमदार है, बहुत ही ज़बरदस्त है. शाहिद का रोल बहुत ज़बरदस्त है, और अभिषेक चौबे जो कि अपनी जिस तरह की फिल्में बनाते हैं उसमें बहुत पॉपुलर हैं वो, और बड़े माहिर आदमी हैं. और उड़ता पंजाब की स्क्रिप्ट जो है वो बहुत अमेजिंग है, वो यंगस्टर्स के साथ, यूथ के साथ बहुत कनेक्ट करेगी.
मुझे एज अ फिल्म मेकर लिविंग, ओके आई स्पीक टू यू, आई थिंक एज अ फिल्म मेकर अगर आपको कोई कहानी बहुत पसंद आ जाती है तो आप चाहते हैं कि उसे पर्दे पे लाएं, और एक जो जर्नी है वो फिल्म मेकिंग की हमेशा से ही टफ रहा है, बट यू डोंट नो कि व्हाट इज द वे अंटिल यू स्टार्ट वॉकिंग द पाथ. सो आई वॉक दैट पाथ, और जो जो चीज़ें मुझे ज़रूरी थी करने की मैंने किया, बट अब आशा करता हूँ कि ये फिल्म आ रही है और जो आपने देखा वो पसंद आया होगा. हमारी इस फिल्म में हमारा अप्रोच ये था कि एक ऐसी स्टोरी हो जिसका कि आत्मा बहुत इंडियन हो, बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली हमारा बीइंग हम इंडियन है, बट उसको मैंने एक पैकेजिंग किया है थोड़ा यूनिवर्सल ऑडियंस के लिए. तो मुझे लगता है कि हमारी फिल्म भी दुनिया में और लोगों को देखना चाहिए, नॉट ओनली जस्ट इंडियंस. सो ये हमारा एक एफर्ट है उस डायरेक्शन में, बट आई होप कि इंडियंस ऑल ऑफ अस वॉच दिस फिल्म, क्योंकि लैंग्वेज इज अ नॉन इशू नाउ डेज. यू नो फास्ट एंड फ्यूरियस हैज डन सो वेल इन इंडिया, तो लोग ये पिक्चर तो देख ही रहे हैं. सो आई एम होपफुल कि इस फिल्म को भी उस तरह का एक रिस्पॉन्स मिले ऑडियंस. We want to have a big release, then only we'll be able to have that wide audience, and that is only possible अगर आप थिएटर्स में लगाएंगे. जब तक बाजू के थिएटर में नहीं अवेलेबल तो फिर लोग फिल्म कैसे देखेंगे. सो दैट्स वाई वी वॉन्टेड दैट लेट द फिल्म बी अवेलेबल, देन दे मे से ओके आई लाइक टू ट्राई दिस इंडियन फिल्म, एंड इफ दे लाइक इट देन इट विल ग्रो. सो इट्स जॉब ऑफ एज अ as a producer it's my job कि फिल्म अवेलेबल हो हर ऑडियंस को हर कंट्री में, एंड देन दे शुड डिसाइड whether they like to watch or not. But I think कि अभी तक जो रिस्पॉन्स मिल रहा है उससे लगता है कि इस फिल्म की एक अच्छी लाइफ हो. मुझे तो लगता है कि अब जैसे आप लगान देखिए या आप इकबाल देखिए, जो जो फिल्मों में एक अच्छी कहानी थी वो कहानी स्पोर्ट्स को भी लेके चली है. सो आई थिंक कहानी अच्छी स्ट्रांग कहानी होना बहुत ज़रूरी है. कहानी अच्छा है, इमोशन करेक्ट है, तो स्पोर्ट्स या जो उसका बैकड्रॉप है वो भी अच्छा लगता है लोगों को. सो आई एम होपफुल दैट हमारी ऑडियंस को ये एक नया स्पोर्ट देखने का मौका मिले और वो उसको इंजॉय करें. एज अ स्टोरी इट्स अ ब्यूटीफुल स्टोरी. नहीं, उसमें क्या है ना कि जो चीज़ हम रोज देखते हैं, अभी IPL एवरी डे हो रहा है, तो जो एक्साइटमेंट फर्स्ट ईयर में, मैं अपनी बात कर रहा हूँ, तो फिफ्थ ईयर में आदत सी हो जाती है. तो मुझे लगता है कि हमारे देश में हम लोगों को नई नई चीज़ें ट्राई करनी चाहिए. देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग इन दैट. थैंक यू सर. वाई शुडंट वी ट्राई, नहीं अच्छा लगेगा तो कुछ और करेंगे ना, इसमें कोई हमें रोक, हम कबड्डी पे बना लेंगे, अगर करना है तो आदमी कुछ भी कर सकता है, वो आप हमारे ऊपर है कि आप ट्राई करते रहिए। एज अ फिल्म मेकर इज माई जॉब कि हम हर तरह की नई कहानियां लोगों के सामने लाएं। इंडिया में तो इस फिल्म में बहुत सारे एंगल्स हैं, सतीश जी साहब हैं, जुगल है, टॉम ऑल्टर साहब हैं, मैं बॉम्बे में हूँ, एंड ऑल्सो इस फिल्म के अंदर एक बहुत खूबसूरत महाभारत का भी एक अंडरलाइन थीम है इसके अंदर, महाभारत वॉर जो है उसकी भी एक थीम है, तो मुझे लगता है इंडियन ऑडियंस के लिए बहुत कुछ है इसमें एंजॉय करने का, आई थिंक दे शुड हैव अ गुड टाइम, आई एम वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट। मेरे ख्याल से ये फिल्म कोई इंडिया और दूसरे कंट्री वाली फिल्म नहीं है, ऐसी फिल्म है कि एज अ स्टोरी यू कैन एंजॉय। नो, आई वॉन्ट टू ओनली डू कमर्शियल रिलीज, मैं इसको फिल्म फेस्टिवल में एकदम भेजने का कोई इरादा नहीं, ये पब्लिक के लिए फिल्म है, चला तो चला, रिजेक्ट हुआ तो रिजेक्ट हुआ, बट पब्लिक के लिए। बस अब रोड पे खड़े हैं आपके साथ, नहीं चली तो फिर यही से जर्दी नहीं शुरू होगी।